Opposition leader Tony Abbott was this week accused of punching a wall next to the head of a woman who beat him in a student election when he was just 19. Abbott denies it.
It is 35 years ago, 35 long years ago. Barbara Ramjan at different times has been on the record about me, critically on the record about me, and she's never chosen to raise this allegation until just a few days ago.
But Labor fed this into its smear campaign to make Abbott, who's a CFA volunteer, a surf lifesaver, who helps Aboriginal communities in his holidays, seem a savage.
What we know about the Leader of the Opposition is that he is a thug.
Physical and verbal intimidation that is still very much a part of the rhetoric and the practical action of this man.
Joining me is Gerard Henderson, head of the Sydney Institute and author of Media Watchdog, a blog on media bias. Gerard, first, did this punch actually happen?
Well, there is no evidence that it ever happened. The allegations are made 35 years after the event, or the alleged event. There is no independent witness. There is an anonymous person who claims that he saw the swing of the punch start but not land. There is someone else who claims to be a witness but said he didn't see it. So there is no evidence whatsoever. And the only evidence that there is, and I've put it in my Media Watchdog blog on Friday, is what Barbara Ramjan wrote about this matter in 1977 in a couple of letters in Honi Soa, the student newspaper at Sydney University. She was rowing with Abbott. Tony Abbott replied to these letters. And in these contemporary letters, Barbara Ramjan criticises Tony Abbott and his colleagues but makes no such allegation. So there was no contemporaneous evidence. In 1977, when Ms. Ramjan had a chance to make these claims, she didn't make them. And they're finally made to David Marr 3.5 decades after the event, with no independent witness and no contemporaneous evidence. David Marr, as a lawyer, would know that you wouldn't hang a dog on that. That is completely useless material.
So why is it such a story for the Fairfax media and the ABC in particular? I mean, we've seen people like Michelle Grattan of Fairfax write article after article about unsubstantiated claims about Abbott as a teenager, yet for years they've said almost nothing about Julia Gillard, who as a law partner helped to start up a slush fund for a boyfriend under a dodgy name. Now, she says she didn't know what he then did, which was extort $500,000. Double standards here, Gerard?
Well, there are always double standards in the media. I'm not saying the media oppose all Liberals, but many media oppose social conservatives like Tony Abbott. And if you wanted to look at behaviour and what young behaviour leads to in adulthood, have a look at Bob Hawke. I mean, if you look at Blanche Delpacher's biography of Bob Hawke, came out about 30 years ago, Hawke had a very rough past as a young man. He went on to become one of Australia's best prime ministers. So I don't even see the link. But I think there are a lot of journalists in the Canberra Press Gallery, and particularly in the ABC, who don't like Tony Abbott's social conservatism, who have a degree of anti-Catholic sectarianism. They don't like the fact that Abbott's a kind of mainstream Catholic, although he's not that religious if you know him. And they're running this campaign against him. Geraldine Duke, who should know better, accused Tony Abbott of, quote, savagery on the ABC last week. Michelle Grattan has virtually said he's a liar. And even in today's newspaper, the journalists who have been running this story will not report the contemporaneous evidence of Barbara Ramjan from 1977 and Honi Soa because it's not consistent with their story. So what they're happy to do is run with hearsay evidence, which is pretty useless in this case, and they won't look at what happened at the time. So I just think they've got it in for Tony Abbott. I don't think that'll change. The question is whether the electorate cares very much.
Well, I don't know about that either, but Labor must think it works. And I just wonder about their hypocrisy too. I mean, they're running very, very hard on this. This is a party that had one leader, Mark Latham, actually boasted about breaking a taxi driver's arm, and then another leader in Kevin Rudd who abused an RAAF flight attendant until she cried. I mean, this is selective indignation from Labor, surely.
Well, it's partly that, but Labor understands that if they look at the polls, the way they are travelling at the moment, particularly in states like New South Wales, Queensland and Western Australia, they have no hope of winning unless they can discredit Tony Abbott. So I can understand what Labor is doing. They're out to discredit Tony Abbott, to make out he's a savage and a thug. What I can't understand is the journalists who should know better, who should be able to examine evidence, are going along with this line. If I were Tony Abbott, I wouldn't have spoken to David Marr. He was never going to get a decent story out of David Marr. I mean, yep. David Marr is a vicious anti-Catholic sectarian, vicious in the verbal sense. And Tony Abbott was never going to get a good story out of David Marr. If I were advising Tony Abbott, I would tell him to stay away from the ABC, from most ABC programs. As I've written in my Sydney Morning Herald column, for conservative Catholics and conservative Christians, the ABC is hostile territory. People like Mr. Abbott and Cardinal Pell should stay away from it. They'll never get a run there.
Gerard Henderson, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.